Namo Shivaya students. Today in our physics class, we shall start with activity 15.8. Now in our last activity 15.7, we have discussed about how the images are formed, are obtained on the screen by the help of a concave mirror. Okay, so we have learnt about the nature, the size of the image formed by the concave mirror by using concave mirror, lighted candle and the screen. So I have taught you that activity, and I have also explained the use of the concave mirror. It is used in the it is used by the dentist. Okay, so these things I have explained. It is used as a reflector in the torches. So use of concave mirror, how the concave mirror could produce image on the screen. So this one we have already discussed. Now today we shall discuss about the image formation by the convex mirror. Similar kind of thing, only in place of concave mirror we have to use the convex mirror. Now convex mirror, you all know that the mirror which bulges outward. Concave mirror means bulging inward and convex means bulging outward. See this one is the convex mirror, right? The reflecting surface which bulges inward, see inward, it is bulging inward, that this is the concave mirror. And the reflecting part in the mirror, where the reflecting part is bulging outwards. Okay, see this is the reflecting part. Why? Because the reflection takes on this surface, so it is reflecting part and this is the non-reflecting part. Now what happens in the convex mirror, the reflecting portion, it bulges outward. Okay, so this kind of mirror is a convex mirror. This one already I have said you. Now today in this activity, what we have to do, see, now similar activity, the repeat activity 15.7, now with a convex mirror. What activity we have done in case of 15.7? What we have done, we have taken one concave mirror, then a lighted candle and the screen. Now what we have done, we have changed the distance of the lighted candle from the concave mirror. We have placed the candle at different positions and we have obtained the image of the lighted candle on the screen. The screen is made up of cardboard and the white paper pasted on it. So that similar kind of experiment only we shall repeat, but instead of concave mirror we shall take a convex mirror. Convex mirror is easily available. Okay, when the school reopens I will show you. So convex mirror only we shall use in place of a concave mirror. Now we have to record our observations in a table similar to table point 15.1. So this was our table 15.1. So similar kind of thing, distance of the object from the mirror. That means we have to change the distance of the lighted candle from the concave, or here from the convex mirror. First it could be 50 centimeter, that means the distance between the convex mirror and the lighted candle will be 50 centimeter, then decrease the distance to 40, 30 and so on. Now we have to observe that whether the image formed on the screen smaller or larger than the object, that we have to observe, either it is smaller or larger than the object. And then the third column is characteristics of the image. Is the image inverted or erect, or is it real and virtual? Inverted means just the reverse, inverted image. The object's frame is in this direction, but the image will be, the tip position will be at the bottom and the bottom will be at the tip. And erect means straight. And real and virtual means, this one also you know, what is the meaning of real image and what is the meaning of virtual image. Now so real image means the image that could be obtained on the screen. If you see the image has been formed on the screen, that means the image is real image. And if the image could not be obtained on the screen, then that means this is the virtual image. Right, so you will perform the similar kind of activity by using the convex mirror. Could you get a real image at the distance of the object from the convex mirror? Did you get an image larger, or these are all the observations? Okay, so this one you have to note it down. If you have the concave, if you could arrange a concave and the convex mirror, you could perform this activity at your home, or otherwise I will show you later on. Now see, you have studied what are the purposes or use of the concave mirror. Now here the most important thing is where the convex mirrors are used. Now convex mirrors are used in the scooters as the side mirror. See, the cars use the side mirror that is placed, that is attached to the window screen. The mirror that is attached to the window screen known as the side mirrors. Okay, in scooters, vehicles, these are the convex mirrors. Okay, now convex mirrors form images on objects spread over a large area. Okay, so through this image we could see, it could show the image of larger area behind the back or behind the road. Okay, it could share the screen where the images of larger area are reflected. Okay, that means convex mirror can form the images of the objects spread over a large area. So these help the drivers to see the traffic behind them. Okay, so as a result it is beneficial for the drivers because they could see the area behind, or they could track the traffic behind them. Okay, so these are the purpose of the convex mirror. Now let us move to the lens. Now images formed by the lens. Now see, you all have seen this kind of magnifying glass. Many of you have this magnifying glass at your home. This magnifying, what is the purpose of this magnifying glass? Magnifying glass means we all know that it helps in magnifying the objects, right? See these letters, these words, which I see, these, suppose let us consider these words, the printed words in your book. Now if you bring one magnifying glass, you will see the enlarged size of the prints, right? Enlarged or magnified. That means magnifying glass helps us in magnifying the image. Magnifying means to see the image in a very large way. Now you might have seen a magnifying glass. This is page number 183 of your NCERT book. Okay, it is used to read very small print. You might have also used it to observe the body parts of cockroach or an earthworm. That means very tiny objects, or very like cockroach, earthworm, this kind of insects, they are very tiny. So in order to see their body parts in a magnified way and close to our eye, the broader vision, for that reason we use this magnifying glass. Now actually this magnifying glass is actually a type of a lens. Okay, is a lens. You all have heard, you all are familiar with the word lens. So magnifying glass, this kind of thing is a lens. Now you have studied about mirror, concave mirror and convex mirror. Now lens also, we have two kinds of lens, convex lens and concave lens. Okay, now this concave lens and convex lens and concave lens, there are many kinds of concave and convex lens. These you shall read in the higher classes. Okay, so but mainly there are two types of lens. One is concave lens and the other is the convex lens. Now I shall say you what is the difference between the lens and the mirror. So anything which helps us in magnifying, that is a type of a lens. Now you all know that the person suffering from the eye defects, they use spectacles. So our spectacles are also using the lens. So spectacles are also using the lens. Telescope, microscope is used for what purposes? To see the body parts of living objects. Okay, so microscopes is you helps us in magnifying the images. We could also see the cell tissues by the help of the microscopes. That means what? They are helping in. So microscopes have lens which helps us in seeing the magnified image close to our eye. So microscopes also use lens. Telescope, which is used to see the distant objects, the far off objects, for that galaxies or satellites, for the planets. So we use telescopes in seeing the distant objects close to our eye. So it helps in magnifying the image. That means the telescopes, microscopes all used lenses. So what is there in telescope and microscope? Lenses are attached to the these special instruments in order to see. Now if you have some lenses, I will show you. Now by touching and feeling them, we can see some differences just by touching. If you see the lens, which is thicker in the middle than at the edge. Edge means the corner. These are the edge, and this one is the middle portion. Now, if you find out the lens very thicker in the middle, by touching only you will be able to understand. Thicker in the middle, but they are very thin at the edges. They are the convex lens. Convex lens means again bulging outward. Okay, mirror was, in the mirror we have seen only one curved surface, but in lens two curved surface are bulging outward. That means the middle portion is thicker one and at the edge it is thinner. So these kind of lens is known as the convex lens. Okay, the concept is same, the bulging outward, okay, but in both the side. And concave lens means thinner in the middle. See, thinner in the middle, but at the edge they are thick. Okay, so these are the concave lens. So concave lens means bulging inward. See, you have learned about the concave mirror bulging inward. Here also bulging inward, but both the side. Okay, but both the side. And in the middle, in the concave lens, they will be thinner. If you touch the concave lens, you could understand easily that in the middle of the lens it is very thin, but if you touch at the edge you will see they are thick. So these kind of lens is known as the concave lens. So convex means bulging outward, that means thicker at the middle, and as concave lens bulging inward, that means inward bulges, there is bulging in the inward direction, that means it will be thin in the middle and thick at the edges. Okay, now lenses are transparent. You have all studied about you know what is transparent, translucent and opaque objects, right? So transparent means what? That allows the light completely to pass through it. So lenses are transparent in nature. Okay, all the lenses, whether it is concave or convex, they are transparent in nature. That means light could easily pass through them. Understood? So these are all about lenses. Now the activity, or in more details, we shall do in our next activity, that is 15.9, in our next class. Okay, so till this you go through activity 15.8 and just go through this 15.5. okay, how the images are formed by the lens, what is the purpose of the magnifying lens, what are the two kinds of lens, how they look like, and also practice the diagram in your copy. Understood? So what is concave lens, what is convex lens, these two questions you will write. Convex lens means the lens which is bulging outward and thicker at the middle and outer edge is thin, but in concave lens thinner in the middle and at the edge it is thick. So these are the two kinds of lenses, the definition you will write, and what is magnifying glass, and lenses are used in spectacles, telescope, microscopes. Okay, so these some points, you just make some bullets and write it down in your copy. Okay, Namah Shivaya.